9 or 10 years ago, Mr. Llewellyn S. Haskell bought a wild tract of mountainous land about as large as Central Park, puzzling the neighbors by the apparent unreasonableness of such a purchase. Everybody asked, what will he do with it?
Hi, I'm Bill Westheimer, and this is Bill Davis, a new resident to the park and a filmmaker and director of our new film, The Secrets of Llewellyn Park.
So why do we call it Secrets? Llewellyn Park has a lot of secrets. One of the secrets that we're researching as we shoot the film is the truth about the house that was a part of the Underground Railroad. And there's been a legend that there was a tunnel under the house. Well, in the course of researching for the film, we found the tunnel.
You never knew this was here?
We never knew about it.
Why would this have been built? There might be an opening in the house. There might be a side tunnel to a house. If it comes out of the house, the high likelihood it was used for people getting in and out. I'm just an engineer, but this excites me.
My name is Joe Cassini. I've been a resident of Llewellyn Park for almost 60 years, and I love classic cars. The car has to have eyeball appeal to me. It has to lift my skirt, so to speak. It's very fitting for this car to reside here because this carriage house was built at the turn of the century, and this is a 1934 Packard. The concours at Pebble Beach that we just participated in, it's been called the Super Bowl of car shows, the Olympic of car shows, and this car won its class, and we were fortunate enough to come away with Best in Show. When you win Best in Show at Pebble, the car has been recognized as one of the finest in the world.
One of the oldest houses in Llewellyn Park is Castlewood, a giant stone castle up at the top of the park. Now it's owned by Meredith and Anthony Ferrara.
Anthony Ferrara told us about an incident that happened to him in which he came face to face with the history of the castle.
One Sunday afternoon, I was at the front of the house and this elderly man pulled up and asked me if I knew where the house called Castlewood was. And I said, well, you're right in front of it. And he said, my grandfather used to tell us a story when we were kids about living in the house for a couple of months. And he remembers being up in a big room overlooking New York during the big celebration after the Civil War, and fireworks were going off. And he remembers seeing the name Castlewood in the stained glass. And this is the window. And he said, boy, we used to think grandfather was crazy, but now we know that the story is true.
We're in Bill and Lisa Westheimer's house, which was actually a stable 100 years ago.
This house used to be the carriage house to a large estate owned by John Burke. And his beautiful young daughter, Mabel, went out for a carriage ride one day, overturned the carriage, and died. The groom who had hitched the horses to the carriage felt guilty about the accident. And some say that his spirit still haunts this house.
I just remember waking up in the middle of the night, just seeing this young man dressed in like riding breeches, bending over the bed, looking at me very curiously. The minute we made eye contact, he went and disappeared.
The thing that strikes me is that you look like Mabel Burke.
That's the whole trouble.
I don't want to know that. Well, what Peggy said to me, just tell him that you're Mabel and that you forgive him and maybe he'll go away. And I'm like, I'm not going to lie to a ghost.
After several years of industrious work, Llewellyn Haskell's wilderness has been transformed into an enchanted fairyland. Now the seat of about 25 completed residences, all bordering upon the central common of original wilderness. Moreover, every estate was designed to be an adjunct of every other, separated not by fences, but by skillful hedges or evergreen trees, so that the fortunate purchaser of 2 or 3 acres becomes a virtual owner of a country estate that challenges comparison with the Duke of Devonshire's.
Once upon a time in Llewellyn Park, a big deal was made of Halloween. And they wanted to know if we wanted to go down and see Mr. Edison. Well, I didn't know who Mr. Edison was. And I said, surely I'd love to go down and see Mr. Edison, whoever he is. He was an old, old man sitting in a rocking chair in his foyer. He always gave us a gold piece, which my mother took home and put away. And he had this big horn sticking out of his head, about 12 inches of horn. And I couldn't figure out what this horn was sticking out of his ear for. It turned out that this was part of his hearing device. So we would talk into this horn and then he would talk to us. And I can't ever remember being so having so much fun with an old man.
Those are just a few of the secrets of Llewellyn Park. There are many more, many that we are in the process of filming or haven't filmed yet. And if you have family films dating from the 20s, 30s, 40s that were shot in Llewellyn Park, please let us know.
If you have family stories that you want to share with us, we'd love to hear them.
Thank you for your interest, for your participation, and we look forward to seeing Secrets of Llewellyn Park together with you.